The last session of the NGO committee witnessed the rejection of a significant number of NGO applications on spurious or politically motivated grounds. The NGO committee must follow the rules that govern its work in a proper fashion.
That more than 70% of organizations that apply and that are in the business of defending human rights are systematically deferred their application.
We have been continuously observing the protracted mistreatment of a number of applications. The membership of the committee has been abused in a way that it undermines the purposes of this organization and the stronger engagement of the civil society in the work of the United Nations.
We see that the NGO committee far too often fails to recommend consultative status to non-governmental organizations for reasons that have little to do with the principles outlined by ECOSOC Resolution 1996/31 and appear to have all to do with political motivations. We are seriously troubled by the willingness of the committee to set aside the rules of procedures established by ECOSOC.
This is not being consistent with its mission. Delaying or even rejecting submissions for political reasons or as sanctions or reprisals.
NGOs from developing countries particularly suffer from sluggish evaluation processes which are of doubtful legitimacy and which go beyond the criteria that really regulate the granting of consultative status.
It is therefore of great concern that systematic action is being taken by a number of governments to suppress the legitimate activities of civil society, including by human rights defenders, NGOs, and journalists.
That the withdrawal of consultative status may be used as a form of reprisal for the activities.